Damning emails provide evidence of the Obama DOJ's abuse of power. There is now damning evidence that Obama's DOJ abused their power and destroyed countless lives doing it. Emails written by Obama DOJ officials confirm reports the agency engaged in a systematic effort to funnel money to liberal advocacy organizations. They did this from settlements reached with big banks. The chairman of the House Judiciary Committee says he has obtained a smoking gun email piece of evidence that proves the Obama Justice Department prevented settlement payouts from going to conservative-leaning organizations. This happened even as liberal groups were awarded money. DOJ officials denied picking and choosing recipients. It is not every day in congressional investigations that we find a smoking gun, Representative Bob Goodlatte said. Here, we have it. And I take this very personally. We lost a home in 2008 that we had no late payments on. We had to sell it to move for work and the bank would not refinance it because our history of payments was too good. The home eventually went into short sale and we wound up having to pay $20,000 to get out of it. So yeah. This ticks me off. Eric Holder oversaw all of this corruption. The DOJ allowed prosecutors to strike agreements compelling big companies to give money to outside groups not connected to their cases to meet settlement burdens. Republicans have long labeled this a slush fund for liberal groups. Trump's DOJ ended the practice earlier this year. Internal Justice Department emails released by Goodlatte indicate that not only were officials involved in determining what organizations would get the money, Justice Department officials may have intervened to make sure the settlements didn't go to conservative groups. One of those emails expressed concerns about what groups would receive settlement money from Citigroup. It said that they didn't want money going to a group that does conservative property rights legal services. Obama and his DOJ funneled money to radical leftist groups. Concerns include, A. not allowing Citi to pick a statewide intermediary like the Pacific Legal Foundation, does conservative property rights legal services, wrote one official. His name was redacted in the email. He wrote under the title of Acting Senior Counselor for Access to Justice. The official further stated that we are more likely to get the right result from a stat bar association affiliated entity. Enter the Pacific Legal Foundation and their dead-on snark. We are flattered that the previous administration would be concerned enough about our success vindicating individual liberty and property rights to prevent settlement funds from making their way to Pacific Legal Foundation, PLF CEO Stephen D. Anderson said. Aiding their political allies was only the half of it, Goodlatte said. The evidence of the Obama DOJ's abuse of power shows that Tony West's team went out of its way to exclude conservative groups. The documents indicate West played an active role in helping certain organizations obtain settlement information. Can you explain to Tony the best way to allocate some money to an organization of our choosing? Principal Deputy Associate Attorney General Elizabeth Taylor wrote in one November 2013 email. There is no doubt whatsoever now that the Obama administration and his DOJ were the most corrupt in our history. Much more is going to come out on all this. This all stems from predatory mortgage lending practices. Millions of Americans were affected by this. When the settlements came down, we received a lousy $200. Not much for destroying someone's life. Obama was a monster, and this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to his corruption.